Hi, in today's video, we'll replace the main battery on my Mercedes CLS shooting brake. Stay tuned! Hi, welcome to my channel. I really hope you enjoy the kind of content that I do. If you like it, please consider subscribe and activate the notification button. My name is Sérgio Monteiro, and this is my Mercedes CLS shooting brake from 2013. In today's video, we're gonna replace the main battery because it's pretty done. So, come with me and let's start to do it. So, on these cars, the battery is located below this cover here. It's really simple to take. You just have like one clip here, and one there. You just loose by hand these three clips, just like this. And the third one in the back, it rotates, and now the cover, it's totally loose. And here we have the original battery. It's a 800 amps battery from Varta, AGM, really important AGM battery. And we will replace it with our well-known Varta F21 with the same specs and of course AGM battery. I will gonna take just these guys over here from both sides so my bonnet will open completely and it will allow me to access easily to the bracket that holds the battery in place. So if you don't know it, to take this out, you just need to get a flat screwdriver, a small one, and slide it in behind the metal part here on the head, push it out, and you're free. The other one just fell off because it was already loose, and now your bonnet will open really, really wide. Okay? It will come up like this. And now the access is much simpler. So now we'll need to go inside. You see? That right down there. Let's see if it's focused. No. That bolt right there, we need to take it and the bracket will come loose. After that, we disconnect the positive and then the negative. In this case, I will connect my jump starter to the auxiliary terminals, the positive and the negative. So in this way, I will not lose any of the codes in the car and any of the codification. So I just simply will replace the battery and everything will stay as it was. The minus or the downside for this operation is you need to be extra careful so the positive will not touch any metal part around here because the wires will be live because we will be fitting the car with the jump starter. So for that I will just use like a small box that I will put on top of the positive terminal while I replace the battery. So let's do it. So I have everything ready now. I have my jump starter here, ready to connect to the car. I have a card box, so I can protect the positive. And I have already the 13mm to loose the bracket that holds the battery in place, and the 10mm to loose the terminals, the negative and the positive. One more thing. Don't forget to take out the vent fitting is this one. Just need to push it out. It will pop out like this, and then just connect it to the new battery because it has the vent in both sides, so you can easily connect it. Just I usually lose it immediately, so I don't start to unbolt stuff and push stuff, and then I will be connected with just a stupid pipe. So first I will start to take the bolt for the bracket.
Here it is. So now the battery is loose. I can take out the bracket itself. It's really simple, you see. It just clamps the battery, and you just need to one bolt to hold it in place. Now the battery is already loose. So next thing, connect the jump starter to the auxiliary terminal. So just put it here nice and secure over the engine cover. Connect the positive terminal and then the negative, and it will beep. Okay, didn't beep, but it's nice and secure. It's connected, it is showing me the voltage. So now, pop this cover and save it, because we will use it again to cover the positive. And with a 10mm socket, just undo the terminal. When it is loose enough, I just take the card box and put this guy in. Now the negative. And our battery is free. So the old battery is out now. I just want to make sure that this positive touch nothing. Okay. Usually I inspect the battery compartment to find for some corrosion or some problems, but in this case it's all okay. It's everything really nice. So the next move now is to put the new battery in. One more time, be really careful with that positive, because it's, do not forget that it's live now. So I will just take the box just to make it a little bit easier to push, to slide the battery in. I will hold it in my hand. Okay, it touched nothing, so it's safe now. So, first thing, the vent, connect to the hole in the place, it's done. That is the first I disconnect and the first I connect, so I don't have to think about that again. Next, I will plug immediately the positive, so in that way I avoid to have some problem and that touch some metal part in the car. So now with my positive really tight, put the cover in, so the positive, it's protected. Now, just take the battery cover from the negative and connect it there. Okay. Now, Okay, the shape of the battery, this is a little bit taller. So it is nice and tight. Now I can remove my jump starter. Just close here the cover. And now align the battery and clamp it in place again with the bracket. And now just place the cover again. Make sure that it is well aligned. And to put the struts in, you just need to push them. Now we don't need to use the flat screwdriver. Okay, in fact I notice right now that if you they are long enough, if you push them, they will hold the hood up. I didn't do this. It's not necessary to take them, okay? Just take that in consideration. And so guys, the battery is replaced. Let's test it. Okay, nice and easy. No big problems. Battery replaced. Okay, radio is working, everything is fine. Let's see, windows properly, so we didn't lose any of the codes of the car. Let's see the sunroof. Yeah. It's all working properly. So one more time, thanks for watching. If you like what you see, please subscribe and activate notifications. Bye.